Hey there, Cerevic people. How are you today? So I'm going to discuss about the electroplating and its connection with the redox reactions. And this lecture is basically for grade 8 to 10 students, wherein I would be explaining the connection between the electroplating as well as the redox reaction. So here I have addressed three important questions. What do you want to electroplate? With what you want to electroplate? And what should be the suitable electrolyte for carrying out this experiment? So now here is the setup. This rod is connected with the positive terminal of the battery. So I'm going to call this as anode. Many of the people have commented that there is a bit confusion between the anode and cathode. You must always understand one thing, that positive one is always the anode. That is not a true definition. Anode is an electrode where oxidation takes place. Because what happens if you are using a battery and the positive terminal is connected with a rod, then that becomes anode. But in case of galvanic cell, the reverse happens. So I don't want you to pull in and drag you into the more confusing part. But I must always say that here, since you are using a battery, this is anode, positive terminal is anode, and here oxidation is going to take place. Whereas if you are actually making your own battery, the one which would be positive would be actually a cathode, right? So just remember that the anode is the one where the oxidation takes place, and this is connected with the negative terminal. So I'm going to call this as cathode, right? This is cathode. Now, here is a copper coin that is shown to you, correct? So this is a coin of copper, and since the copper coin on a longer run turns greenish in color when it is exposed to air and humidity, right? So we want to preserve this coin, and I want to give it as a shiny look. So here what I want to electroplate is a copper coin. Then that copper coin has to be made cathode. What do you want to electroplate? You need to connect it with the negative terminal of the battery and make it as a cathode. And I decide to electroplate this with silver. So I want to electroplate this copper coin with silver. So I'm going to take a pure rod of silver and I'm going to make it as anode. So this is a pure silver rod. Correct? This is a pure silver rod over here. Now, the electrolyte compulsorily has to be a compound of the anode element. So here, or I wanted to electroplate this copper coin with silver, so I require an electrolyte of silver only. So I'm going to consider silver nitrate solution as the electrolyte over here. So basically AgNO3 is what is going to be the electrolyte. So this is electrolyte, this liquid over here. Which is a compound of the silver rod itself, right? Now, what is going to happen? The moment you switch on this circuit, the electric current will pass through the circuit, and this AgNO3 will split up into Ag plus 1 and Cl minus 1, sorry, NO3 minus 1. So the electric current is going to break this entire compound into Ag plus 1 and NO3 minus 1. So here I'm going to show the reaction of only one single molecule, and there are crores of molecules over here. So there are a lot of AgNO3 molecules over here, and one such molecule is going to break up into NO3 minus 1 and Ag plus 1. So here is Ag plus 1. And NO3 minus 1. Now, since Ag plus 1 is positive, so it would try to go towards a negative plate, which is cathode. So this Ag plus 1 will go to the cathode and it will stick over here. Correct? So this Ag plus 1 is going to stick over here, thereby creating a vacancy over here, because now this Ag plus 1 has already shifted over here. So now there is a vacancy of Ag plus 1 in the solution. Now, since NO3 is a heavier ion, so it can't go towards the anode with that much faster speed. So I'm going to consider this as a heavy ion and it does not move towards the cathode. Ideally, it should, because it's a negative ion and it should be getting attracted towards the anode positive. But since this is a heavy negative ion, so I'm going to keep it over here. It remains as over here only. So now there is a silver ion vacancy just near the NO3 minus 1 ion. Now what is going to happen? This silver rod is made up of silver atoms. So this is a silver atom, Ag. Now this silver atom is going to lose one electron. It vomits one electron outside and converts into positive ion, because now since this silver atom is losing one electron, it will become positive ion. So this will become Ag plus 1, which will enter into the solution to fulfill this vacancy. And since this is negative electron, it will be attracted in the upward direction by the battery, and the battery is going to flush out this electron on the other side, and this electron will go towards the cathode, and the earlier silver ion which was waiting over here will be receiving that particular electron, and it will get converted into silver atom. Because this is plus one and it will receive one electron, it will convert into silver atom. So I'll show you the reaction after a short while, but you need to understand what is happening over here, guys. See, first of all, when you pass the electric current, AgNO3 splits up. This Ag plus 1 ion gathers over here, thereby creating a vacancy over here. Now the silver atom breaks up into silver ion and enters over here, losing an electron. That electron goes via the external circuit, and that is being gained by the silver ion which was previously gathered over here. So now let us write the reaction. Here at anode, what is happening? Ag, silver atom, lost one electron to form Ag plus 1. This is loss of electron, so oxidation. And over here, Ag plus 1 was waiting and it took one electron from the external circuit and converted into silver atom. So in that way, a lot of silver atoms would be gathering around. A lot of silver atoms would be losing the electrons and again entering into the solution. So if you see that, the amount of solution will never decrease. And slowly and steadily, since you are using up the silver atoms, this rod will become thinner and thinner. So indirectly, the atoms converting into ions entering over here, the ions are shifted over here, getting converted into atoms and gathering over here. I don't want to go into much of the detail part, that how the uniform distribution and all those takes place, but this is what is important to understand, that this is reduction, this is oxidation taking place at anode, and the reduction takes place at cathode, and the reactions are stated as under. So hopefully, guys, you have enjoyed the explanation. Please subscribe my channel if you have not done so. Thank you for watching the video.